Now let's look at the Buckingham Pi theorem. Now in Rayleigh's method, we looked at method to solve the dimensional analysis problem when you have a maximum of 4 variables. And we looked at in an example that when the variables increase by 4, then it becomes very complex to tackle the problem. So in this, we can be very rest assured that the tackling of variables becomes very easy if they are more than 4. So let us say you have n total variables, and m out of them are fundamental variables. So n minus m dimensionless variables would have to be formed, and these dimensionless variables are called pi terms. Okay, and we'll have to choose repeating variables to create these pi terms. Repeating variables. So how do you choose a repeating variable? A repeating variable should not be chosen if it is dependent. Okay, so if you remember the last question, that is that the resistance force is a function of length of the aircraft, velocity, the viscosity of the air, the density of the air, and the bulk modulus of the air. Right, so this means that R is a function of LV mu rho k. It is LV mu rho and k. Okay, I can rewrite this as R LV mu rho and k equal to 0. This means this has how many total variables? This has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 total variables. Okay. So I would say n is equal to 6. The number of fundamental variables would be 3 in this case. M, L, and T. So the number of fundamental variables are 3. And the number of pi terms that have to be formed are 3. This means I have to choose repeating variables. Okay. Now look at these variables. You cannot have R as a repeating variable because R is dependent upon LV, mu, rho and k. Okay, so how do you choose a repeating variable? So repeating variables should be chosen in this manner. So at least one of the repeating variables should have a geometric property. It should also have one of the repeating variables should have a flow property, and the repeating variables should also have a fluid property. Okay, so this is the criteria on which we'll choose our repeating variables. So R cannot be the repeating variable, so I have to choose 3 repeating variables. So a variable which gives you a geometric property is length. So L becomes one repeating variable. The flow property is given by the velocity. What kind of flow is it? So V becomes the second repeating variable. The fluid property is given by density. So these are my 3 repeating variables. So if I have to write down the pi terms, okay, so the first pi term is pi 1. Okay, this is equal to L A1 into V B, V to the power B1 into rho to the power C1 into, now out of these 3, R, mu and K are left. So I'll write down R over here, because every pi term will have m plus 1 terms. M means the number of fundamental variables plus 1. Okay, so it has to have 4 terms in it. So pi 2 would be how much? L to the power A2 into V to the power B2 into V to the power B2 into rho to the power C2 into viscosity. And pi 3 would be L to the power A3 into V to the power B3 into rho to the power C3 into bulk modulus. Okay, so when you find these 3 terms, the function f1 can be written as f of pi 1, pi 2 and pi 3 equal to 0. This is how you can write it down. Okay, so let's find out these values. So the dimensions of L, V and rho are known to us. So let's write them down. So the dimension of L, length, is L. The dimension of velocity is L t minus 1. The dimension of density is M L to the power minus 3. Then you have the dimension of capital R, which is nothing but force, which is M L t to the power minus 2. Then we will find out the dimension of mu. The dimension of mu is how much? M L minus 1 t minus 1. And the dimension of K, or bulk modulus, is M L minus 1 t minus 2. Alright, so we have the dimensions of these terms. So let's write down each and every dimension. So we have to make sure that each of these pi terms are dimensionally homogeneous. So this is a constant, so the dimension will be 0, m to the power 0, l to the power 0, and t to the power 0. So let's start with pi 1. So you will have m 0, l 0, t 0. Okay, then you will have L to the power A1 into L T minus 1 to the power B1 into M L to the power minus 3 into C1 into M L T minus 2. That is for R. So let's resolve this. So you will have M0, L0, T0. Let's write down for M. So you will have M to the power C1 plus 1. Okay, so it's C1 from here and plus 1 from here. L would be A1 plus B1. Let's write it down. A1 plus B1. Then you have minus 3C1 and plus 1. Okay, then you have T. T would be minus B1 minus 2. So now you can equate these two powers. So you will have C1 plus 1 equal to 0. Okay, so I will write down C1 as minus 1. B1 minus B1 minus 2 is equal to 0. So B1 would be minus 2. So you have B1 and you have C1. So from here I can find out A1. So A1 minus 2 plus 3 plus 1 equal to 0. So this is 4 minus 2, it is 2. So A1 will become minus 2. So when you put in the values in this, the first pi term will be pi 1 is equal to L to the power A1, A1 is minus 2. So you will have L to the power minus 2, V to the power B1, which is again minus 2. Okay, then you have rho to the power C1, which is minus 1, and then you have R. This means pi 1 can be written as R upon rho V square into L square. So this is pi 1. Similarly, I can find out pi 2. So for pi 2, I can rewrite it as M0 L0 T0 equal to L to the power A2 into L T minus 1 to the power B1. Then we have M L minus 3 to the power C2. This will be B2 as well. And then mu. Mu is M L minus 1 T minus 1. M L minus 1 T minus 1. So let's combine these things. So you will have for M first, M to the power C2 plus 1 into L, you will have A2 plus B2 minus 3C2 and then minus 1. And then we come for T. T would be minus B2, minus B2 and then minus 1. Now you can put C2 plus 1 equal to 0 and then B minus B2 minus 1 equal to 0. So from here I can get C2 is equal to minus 1. Then I will get b2 is equal to minus 1. So when you put c2 and b2 over here, you can get the value for a2. So that will be a2 minus 1 plus 3 minus 1 equal to 0. And this is 3 minus 2, which is 1. So a2 will also be minus 1. Okay, so you can put a2 minus 1, b2 minus 1, c2 minus 1. This will give you the value for pi 2. So pi 2 will be mu over L V rho, because everything is minus 1. It becomes very easy. So pi 2 becomes mu over L V rho. That's the density. So now the last would be to find out the value for pi 3. So pi 3 would be again m0, L0, T0. This would be L to the power A3 into L T minus 1 to the power B3, and then M L minus 3 to the power C3 into K. K's unit are M L minus 1 T minus 2. You'll have M L minus 1 T minus 2 to the power nothing, just 1. So let's combine. You'll have M, you'll have C3 plus 1, then we'll have L, which is A3 plus B3 minus C3, C3 minus 1. Then we'll have T, the power of T would be minus B3 minus 2. So from here I can put C3 plus 1 equal to 0, and that would give you C3 is equal to minus 1. B3 would be minus 2, and when you put C3, B3 in here, you will get A3. So A3 minus 2 plus 3 minus 1 would be 0. So minus 2 minus 1 is minus 3 plus 3. This entire thing would be cancelled. So A3 is 0. Alright, so pi 3 would be, so A3 is 0, so there will be no L in this case. So V to the power minus 2 into this, so you'll have K or kappa upon V square into rho. So this is pi 3. Okay, so I can write the function or the equation as this. So you'll have F1 of pi 1. Pi 1 is R upon rho V square L square comma pi 2 mu upon L V rho comma pi 3, which is kappa upon V square rho. This is equal to 0. I need a value for R. So I can rewrite this part as R upon rho V square L square. This is equal to phi of these two values, which is phi of mu upon L V rho comma kappa upon V square rho. So this is the expression that we can get from Buckingham Pi's theorem. So I hope you got it. The main part was to recognize these three terms to find out the repeating variables, and thus we are able to create the three pi terms or three dimensionless variables. Okay, so I hope you got it. Now after these two methods to solve a question on dimensional analysis, let's move on to the next topic and talk about similarity or similitude.